It's like so much love coming from a different planet. Thousands of years ago, many dwelled in the earth, way down below. They existed, the Shiyuk, well-intelligent folk, never interacted with the surface people, or so, but if they did, it was here and there, never tried to get close, or it will get hectic to grow. That's bestowed, the surface people, were ebonoid beings, did not key out. The Afar is what you seen, the inner earth even had an inner sun, many titles it held, and it wasn't like just one, Shambhala, Agartha, Dust, or Amenta, Kanerji, Hades, or the underworld, Tulsi Baba, yo, the Shiyuk, with big people, humanoid and all, ranging from 5 to 7 feet tall, had telekinetic and telepathic abilities, big skulls like they had photographic memory, yeah. Talk of the Sanin tribe adjacent to the other one. Smart brains and cone-shaped heads like no other son. Sanin people were either yellow or brown. The Shiyuk straight ebony with that dark brown. They were also 5 to 7 feet tall. Birthed a tribe called the Samin that made things fall. Sanin and the Shiyuk weren't on common ground. Considering the Samin tribe disturbed their town. Y'all talking pale skin obese, elephant face looking. Destructive with no manners, wondering, looking crooked. So the only way to settle this was to have an exchange. This was insane, forgot to mention. These tribes have kings and the things that it brings. But anyway, this is where it strains. The king of the Shiyuk has 2 jealous brothers and a daughter. The king of the Sanin had a son and a daughter. Fucor, Yishok, Amos, and Radia, Lamsa, Hatif, also Lucina. Lucina and Yishok had an affair with each other, led to pregnancy, and Yishok killed by his brother. A child, knowing his parents for 5 years. His mother often herself bottled many tears. I mean, for real though, it felt like nobody cared. Born with 2 brains, so much angst and despair, yeah. Now orphaned by the age of 6, living with Amos, found himself playing with these metals. Weird combo, inspired by the demonstration, attraction and repel, he decided that he make a tribe to bring hell to all of the ebonoid people. He was upset, blaming on those that look like him. Now he's a wreck, graduated first in his class from college at 18, created the theory of trichnology and wrote up a trichnology 120 degrees, gained a following. This was just a part of him constantly just shallowing his people, told his followers they ruled the planet, making slaves of everyone to take advantage. Of course the king felt inferior to this thought. This was a view of life in his palm. He felt that this man that was smart should be locked up, but that wasn't working, so he gave him an offer up. Yo, this man said he wanted money for his people. He would need 20 years to prepare his scheme to 59k following his nature. He left with 100 ships, ventured to Patmos and Islanders, vacant breath with the women on his ship, got them pregnant, pricking the dark baby's head with a needle. Lighter ones kept present. Those that found out were surprised, huh? Jumping off the ship, his destination, see his followers worth 5%. He raised these babies up, fueled hatred in their minds, told them that God was not a man but a spook in the sky. Experiment of eugenics was led to genocide to the ebonoid people. Yeah, you wonder why. The populace went from ebonoid to rubidoid to centronoid. 600 years it took to make his tribe. The ebonoid went back to the country they came from to bring the pain to the ebonoid people. Eventually they were detained, sent across burning sands to an area that had mountains. There for 2,000 years, making their way back to the founding, putting ebonoid people against each other out of fear, divide and conquer. This went on for 6,000 years.